Addressing journalists at the end-of-year press conference at Parliament today, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, together with other members of the opposition, noted that for the past periods, the electoral and constitutional reforms have been tabled as an afterthought. But this time, they want the constitutional and electoral reforms tabled in earnest so that the citizens have an input.
The excuse, normally you're aware, over the last two parliaments, we have had electoral reforms tabled late, deliberately. This time round, we want to have them tabled in earnest so that citizens have time to have an input in these matters.
He said that they will take the lead in the process in the next half of the second session of Parliament scheduled to commence in January 2023. Mpuuga added that the establishment of the Constitutional Review Commission has been a song from government, but the actualization has not happened and so they can't wait in anticipation.
We're going to take the lead and make these constitutional and electoral reforms our priority in the next session.
According to Mpuuga, currently they have a blueprint that will be shared with other political parties so that at the beginning of the sessions, the reforms are tabled.
So far, a blueprint which we want to share with the rest of the political parties. In the coming days, I'll be able to report to the leading opposition party, the NUP, and they'll give us guidance on this, how this will be shared with other parties, so that our onslaught in the next session will be about tabling in earnest the most considered constitutional and electoral reforms.
Meanwhile, the opposition has underscored the issue of enforced disappearances and torture of opposition supporters as the worst thing that has ever happened to Uganda this year. Mpuuga revealed that they have instructed lawyers to file for habeas corpus in courts of law for all missing persons.
Has never responded or has actually failed to respond to the so many questions we have raised in Parliament and outside Parliament about the disappearance of citizens, the violation of their rights, the killings on the streets, and as you are aware, even this week, at the prompting of the Deputy Speaker, the Prime Minister promised to come and make an account by way of comparing what we are questioning and what they know. And the last meeting was supposed to take place yesterday in the Deputy Speaker's chambers. None of the persons turned up. We are moving to the next level.
The opposition has reiterated the issue of rampant land wrangles perpetuated by notorious individuals protected by security agencies and called upon the public to rise up and defend their land.
Problem is sheer impunity. It's just impunity that is reigning and outright corruption at various levels.
Mpuuga also challenged government to explain the causes and nature of insecurity that is spreading across the country, where gun-wielding men attack police posts and take off with guns after killing police officers in some cases.
Explanations that are coming out are not satisfying. The country demands for more because we believe you know better what is going on.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.